Alright, Maya versus Blender. Two 3D animation apps that are currently being used by lots of people in the 3D animation industries, from newbies to professionals. And in this video, I'm gonna give you an insight to help you decide which application might suit you better for your use cases. As a little bit of background, I'm a student, so this video is gonna be from the perspective of a student. I started with Blender around 2 years ago, and then I use Maya on a daily basis for school for about 1.5 years already. Let's just jump into the video. The pros of Maya. Maya is a general 3D animation app, but it is not as general as Blender. It is extremely good for animation and VFX, and also for modeling. It has very robust tools built in, so from the start you get things like animation layer, for example, for animation, Bifrost node-based VFX system in Maya, but it also has very good physics system like cloth, hair simulation, rigid body physics, and soft body physics. It also has very robust UV toolkit. The NURBS modeling in Maya is just very good. It's a blessing, and some of these tools are really good that it is recreated as add-ons in Blender. Maya is also very customizable in terms of the UI and the hotkeys. I'm not saying that Blender is not customizable, in fact Blender is also very customizable, but not to the point of Maya, because in Maya all can be done from the preferences without requiring extra add-ons. The hotkeys in Maya is also very ergonomic. You can use Maya for extended period of time without tiring your left hand. It may not sound like much, but when you're working in the industry where you'll be pressing the same button thousands of times for days, having a good hotkey is such a blessing. As you can see here that I don't move my left hand too much, and it stays pretty much on the left side of the keyboard. And I'm gonna make a comparison between the hotkeys in Maya and Blender in the next part of this video. Maya is also the standard in the industry. It received lots of add-ons and support from other applications for better integration with Maya. For example, Substance Painter and Unreal Engine has official add-ons for Maya. Sharing projects in Maya also very easy. It's especially good for big enterprises and group projects. You can also do this in Blender, but you can have to set it up yourself. But in Maya, it's already pre-set up by the application, so it's gonna help a lot during the early stages of the project. Maya also has lots of portfolios in movies, games, and VFX. If there's a movie or anything with intensive VFX integrated into the scene, then there is a chance that it was worked on Maya. Now, if you want to work in the industry, especially in big companies, it's always a good idea to know how to use Maya. Now, in short, Maya is the standard of the industry, and Maya does the fundamentals of 3D very, very well. Now, let's jump into the pros of Blender. Now, Blender is a general tool for all things 3D, meaning that it's not the best at anything. Like, it can do texturing very good, but it's not gonna be as good as a Substance Painter. It can do VFX, but it's not gonna be as good as Houdini. It can do 3D modeling, maybe around the same level as 3D Studio Max. It can do animation, but as I said, Maya comes with an animation layer, but Blender does not. It can also do 2D / 3D animation with Grease Pencil, but Blender is catching up with the other standards in the industry and is constantly being updated with tons of quality of life improvements, better performance, and new features like node modeling, particle system, and can handle more complex scenes than ever before. Now, being general doesn't mean that it is bad. In fact, Man of the High Castle uses Blender in their main pipeline. Now, the advantage of being able to do everything in a single app means that you're gonna spend less exporting things, and you're gonna spend less in terms of the money. Blender is also open source, meaning that you can fork it, you can make your own version of Blender if you wish to do that. You can code in it, and thanks to that, there are lots of add-ons that has been worked on Blender. If you have an idea of an add-on, then there is a high chance that someone's already working on it, or it has been made for Blender. And also, thanks to that, experimental features like high denoising and real-time screen space, global illumination are fast to implement on Blender. It has two render engines. First one is Cycles, which is ray tracing and physics-based render engine, which is more lifelike and supports CPU and GPU hybrid rendering. And the second one is Eevee, which is a real-time game-like quality. It's not very lifelike, but it is good enough for certain cases. Now, because having two render engines means that you can choose whether you want the quality, whether you want to speed up the render time. Blender is very light, even on your, if you have a potato PC. First render that I did was on a Windows tablet with no proper cooling, and it had an Intel Atom. Blender is also free, so the barrier for entry is literally zero. And the community of Blender is thriving. It has lots of good and fun tutorials. While Maya has good and fun tutorials as well, I haven't seen as much and as fun tutorials as the ones for Blender. Now let's just jump into the cons of each app. I'm gonna start with Maya again. Maya is a paid app, and it is pretty expensive at that. The student version is free. It only requires your student email or your student card. The light version is also available. It is cheaper, but it cuts down on certain things. But from what I've heard, it's still pretty robust that you can use it. Another cons for Maya is that the big updates come yearly, meaning that experimental features take time to be implemented, like AI denoiser and GPU rendering. Actually, GPU rendering has only been made available for Maya in Maya 2020, so the last year's version. But even then, it was still pretty buggy. Maya also sucks at other things like sculpting and texturing. So if you want to do that, it requires you to get other apps. Fortunately for a student, usually you can get those applications for free, the student privileges. For enterprises, if you're working in big companies, then usually the applications are already paid by the company. Maya is also pretty heavy and it crashes like mad. There are times when I just moved a single vertex and boom, it crashed. Now I'm gonna stop talking shit about Maya. I'm gonna continue with the cons of Blender. Now, if I said before, Blender is the jack of all trades. It is very good at many things, but not the best at anything. It is missing on some necessary basic things, and it requires you to get some add-ons to do things efficiently. For example, animation layer, UV toolkit, because the UV tools in Blender is, in my opinion, it's really bad. And if you want to do retopology, then Quadrimaster will help your workflow much more efficiently. Now, fortunately, the updates for these add-ons are usually free, and getting all that is usually cheaper than getting the Maya application itself. But still, it requires you to do more research, and when new big update comes, the plugin doesn't come exactly at the same time as the Blender update itself. Now, this is also one of the things that that holds back group project in Blender. If, for example, you have an add-on, but your partner, your group partner doesn't have the same add-on, and this project requires this add-on to be able to work together, then your partner has to buy the add-on itself. Sometimes you still have to get other apps. Take sculpting, for example. Over 3 million vertices on Blender, then it's gonna be really slow. But on ZBrush, sculpting with over 5 million vertices, and it remains very smooth. Blender relies too much on hotkeys. And in my opinion, when I work with Blender over a long period of time, it feels like I'm playing a piano. I have to move my left hand too much, and over time it causes strain on my left hand. Now let's get to the verdict, Maya versus Blender. Well, to be honest, it depends on your use case and your goals. If you're in a school, then go get Maya, because it's going to be free, and the other apps as well. And you can also do Blender on the side if you wish to do that. If your plan is to work on big studios, usually Maya, the understanding of Maya is a requirement, so it's always a good idea to learn Maya. Fortunately, as I said before, you don't have to pay Maya when you're working in these big studios. If you're an indie developer or hobbyist, then Blender might be the good choice for you. Now, it doesn't mean that Blender is only good for indie. Blender is catching up on the big industries, as I said before. And the last one is the preference of each and every one of you. Some of you might prefer the workflow in Maya, while some of you might prefer the workflow in Blender. Then again, you shouldn't confuse yourself with the tools that you're going to be using. It's easy to change tools after you get the basics of 3D, because what matters is your art, isn't it? Anyway, that's the end of the video. Do all those YouTube shit, like, comment, subscribe, whatever. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.